Okay, so is this your phonics book?
Yeah.
And have you read it at school with a grown-up?
Yeah.
So you're going to show me your fantastic reading. Brilliant, let's get started. What's the book called?
At the River.
At the River. What do you think they might do in this story?
They might do things at the river.
Have you ever been to a river?
No.
No? Oh. I take my little boy to the river sometimes to feed the ducks, and I think from the picture that this little boy might feed the ducks as well. Okay.
What if I go to a place where there was lots of ducks and feed it?
Oh, brilliant.
I feed it fruit.
Fruit? Oh, I bet that was a nice change from bread for them. Oh, lovely.
Because our ducks can't have bread.
Oh, no, it's not good for them, is it? It upsets their tummy if they have too much. Okay. So, you're going to show off your super sounding out that you've been learning at school? Start on the first page.
At the river.
The river,
yeah. Max and Icklick.
Mm-hmm. Super. I love the way you sounded this bit and this bit. Shall we try putting it together? So we heard Icklick. Thick. Ram. So thick ram. Thick ram. Well done.
A little tail. A w.
Boat. So what are Max and Vikram doing?
Sailing a boat.
Sailing a little boat. Oh, they're going to have a lovely time.
In the river or for the ducks.
See, that's a good thing. Do you remember what he fed them? You fed them fruit. What did Jeff feed the ducks?
Buns.
That's very tasty for them. What happens next? This does look a bit like the sound, but this is a capital Y. What sound that makes?
Yeah.
Well done.
Yeah. Yeah.
Lovely. Much better. Well done.
Fish.
Has she seen a fish?
Yeah.
What colour is it?
Golden.
Golden. Well, I was going to say orange, but that's a really good choice of adjective. Well done.
Tanya.
Well done.
And
do you remember?
Yes.
You almost got you. What's this sound? Shh. So you. Yasha. Do you know what an eel is?
It's like a snake, but it swims in water.
Wow, that is a brilliant definition. Well done. Do you know, I'm hearing lots of sounds, aren't we? We've had Yasmin and Yasha. I wonder if we have any more of those.
Because that mud is definitely using.
Oh, it is. What a good word. Do you think his owner's going to be pleased?
No.
No, I wouldn't be very happy if my dog came home covered in mud. Oh, that's the end. Super. You did some super sounding out there. I can see you've been really practicing your sounds you've learned at school. Shall we have a look at some of these words?
Sure.
super. I'm going to pick one now. I'm going to pick this one.
Fish.
Super. You pick one.
Max.
Oh, Max. I'm going to pick one more because this one is a bit of a tricky word. Have another go at that one.
Wooden.
Wooden. And do you remember what was wooden in the book we just read?
It was the boat.
It was the boat. Super. That was brilliant reading. Well done.
The way home for wolf.
Excellent. What do you think it's going to be about?
A little wolf that wants to find his way back home. Mm.
And what made you choose this one?
Because I love baby wolves.
You like baby wolves? Have you ever seen wolves? No. Oh, I saw wolves at the zoo a few weeks ago with my little boy. And what was amazing is that they were making that noise that wolves make. Do you know what noise I mean?
Howling.
Yes, the howling. That's the right word for it, isn't it? There we go. Ooh, oh, it's brilliant. Super. Okay, I wonder if any of the wolves were howling.
Did you see how they get to eat?
I didn't. Do you know how they eat?
Yeah, they catch their food and then they drag it.
Wow, you do know a lot about wolves. Brilliant. Okay, so The Way Home for Wolf, and it's by Rachel Bright and Jim Field. Okay. It's got some beautiful pictures in this book.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
10 wolves. Super. So, wolf pack. As a rainbow of lights flickered soft in the night, dusting diamonds of ice in a desert of white, the wild whipping wind, it whistled its tune to a howling of wolves and a shimmering moon.
I think that's the ones that got lost.
I think you might be right. He's definitely the smallest, isn't he?
Yeah.
And the loudest, ow! That's that noise you were talking about. In this echoing song was a wolfling called Wilf at the heart of the throng. He loved to be fierce and longed to be grown. He liked to try everything all on his own. Very independent. Look at me, I am big, I am tough, he would growl, whilst he showed off his strength and practiced his prowl. How do you think this wolf is thinking about him? Do you think she's impressed with him showing off his strength? Why not?
Because then he would be not tough.
Not tough. What's he doing to her snow? Or snow wolf, maybe?
Knocking it down.
He's knocking it down. He's trying to show he's so strong and he's knocking it down. He's proud. And a bit like you said about how they catch their prey, he's practicing on this puffin. Who does not look impressed. One night it was time for the wolves to move on. New folks had moved in and their shelter was gone. So why are they having to leave?
Because there's bears in it.
Yeah, the polar bears are taking their home. So they left right away to find a new cave. They would have to walk far and they'd have to be brave. Do you think wolves are brave?
Because they can run.
Let's go, shouted Wilf. I am ready to lead. You're too small, laughed the wolves. It's an elder we need. That's an older wolf. One day, they advised, you will guide from the front. I suppose, muttered Wilf, with a huff and a grunt. How do you think he's feeling now?
Angry.
Angry. Why do you think he's angry?
Because he can't lead the pack.
Yeah, he wants to be in charge, didn't he? They struggled through snow as high as their flanks and leapt over rocks as they scaled icy banks. Wow, so that snow must be really tall because our flank is a bit on our middles here, between our ribs and our hips. That's really tall snow. Wilf gave his all to keep pace and keep up, but strong-willed as he was still just a pup. Quite hard for him to keep up. He kept dropping back with each clamber and climb, as the pack journeyed further away all the time. Oh, there he is, he's quite a way back now. Exhausted and breathless, he strayed off the track when a blizzard blew in. Do you know what a blizzard is?
Not clear.
It's not clear, you're right. And it's like a snowstorm, so not just a little bit of snow, but like snow blowing everywhere. And a blizzard blew in and he lost his way back.
There's no footprint.
There's only his, aren't there? Goodness knows where the other wolves are. Wolf longed to howl, "Help!" and to holler it loud, but his throat was too hoarse and his heart was too proud. He likes to do everything himself and doesn't want to ask for help.
There's all the spirits.
He lay on the tundra, his tail curled up tight. A blanket of stars was his bed for the night. Until crack went the ice, crack and creak. Wolf jumped to all fours with a deafening shriek. He stuck out the claws on every limb. He had to hold on because Wolflings can't swim.
Then he has to go over there.
No, he wouldn't, but look what's happening now. The ice has given way, it's cracked and he's fallen into the water. Then he fell and he fell, rolling and spinning. It felt like the end, but was just the beginning. Since somebody down there had heeded his scream, and she swooped from beneath like a watery dream. "I'll help you," she called, "just reach for my horn." A majestic and magical sea unicorn. Do you think it's a sea unicorn?
It's a narwhal.
A narwhal. You know lots about creatures, don't you? Wolf's pride washed away, and he stretched out a paw as she lifted him gently back onto the shore. "Don't worry," she sung before dipping her brow. "My friend Mr. Walrus will help you out now." And there, right behind him, a huge tusky fellow lifted his whiskers and let out a bellow. "To the ridge," he proclaimed with his chin in the air. "My friend Mighty Muskox will take you from there." And with waftings of fish and a very loud snort, their journey was made and their travel seemed short. That's kind of him helping him. And there, sure enough, on the ridge was the ox, who took Wolf as far as his friend, Arctic Fox, who followed his nose through the trees to a goose, who guided him honking to this ancient moose. The moose knew these wilds like no other soul. He was steady and true in pursuit of their goal. And as twilight closed in, Moose sang out a call to a fluttering, tiny fluffball, a bear moth, who showed Wolf the rest of the way to the place where this wolfling most wanted to stay. Where do you think that place is?
Back to the pack.
"Thank you," Wolf waved as he rejoined his pack, and the wolves howled with joy that their wolfling was back. They huddled him in and cuddled him close, and fussed over which wolf had missed him the most. Wolf, he knew then, that when all come together, the darkest of times are easy to weather.
There's three howling.
They are, aren't they? They must be howling for joy this time. So he bowed to the narwhal, ox, walrus and goose, and bowed to the fox and the moth and the moose. "If ever I meet one who strayed off their track, I'll help them along by guiding them back." And true to his word, Wolf is different now, and his world seems much smaller and warmer somehow.
They were coming down to help.
Do you think so? Is that because you saw them in the sky on that other picture?
Oh. I just saw the narwhal.
Oh, I see. On this one. It's all of them, isn't it? Mm. And then here they are again after they've helped him. "Since wherever life takes you, wherever you roam, we're all just a handful of friendships from home." Oh, so he did find his way back with some help from his friends. That was really kind. Yeah. Whose footprints do you think those might be? Wolf's. Yeah, I think so too. Oh, did you like that story?
Yeah.